City Gays Christian Center podcast, bringing a message of hope to the lonely, broken, and wounded.
All right. Very excited today for the second part of our love series. Well, let's be praying. Father, thank you, Lord, for your goodness. And thank you for your love that you've shown us. Your love, Lord, is unfathomable. So deep, so wide, so high. God, your love is unconditional. Holy Spirit, today we yield to you and we say, God, we want to know more of you. As we pray in Jesus' name, amen. Last week we talked about characteristics of true love and that God's love for us knows no discrimination, knows no difficulty, deceit, or doubt. And we had fun last night at Catalyst Youth in our rendition of Bucket List ng Pag-ibig. And we talked about bakit hindi pa pwede. And as I've said, we had lots of fun. And it's not that waiting can be like this. Dili i-check ng lana ang klaseng magpapaabot. It's just that we're able to talk about the goodness of God, the faithfulness of God, and that God has someone for each one of us. Hindi mo kapag naiganda lang ito para ninyo. Masigap ko na. I also like to mention, coming up, anybody who has a date already on February 14th? Well, for everyone who wants to have a date with you, we have our Awit Para Nimo. It's our special date with the Lord. Alright, that is our event this coming February 14th. This morning, as what I said last week, everybody deserves true love. God is the author of love. Never fails, never changes. His intention is the same. And that is to make you secure and to tell you, even this very moment, that even wala kay day, even if you failed at times or many times in your life, and even if you think that you do not deserve true love, God loves you. And in 1 John chapter 4, verse 16, it says there, we know how much God loves us, and we have put our trust in His love. God is love. He is love. It is His nature. God is love. And all who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. Amazing how, you know, at times we forget. We try to love others, but ato gugma gugmatoy. Our love for, you know, the people around us are so conditional. So this boy goes to the girl, okay, you know, siya matay, dili na tao, dili na hayop kung samanta. Mga babae na, bagay, utay, bagay lang mo. Okay. Nagagay mga palusot, nagagay mga hugon, and all those things. To everyone looking for true love, this morning, this one is for you. Talk about loves me, he loves me not. It's among you. Now, we look at this and we find expression or God's language of love. We find, you know, types of relationship. And our objective today is that we understand that it is the love of God. Love of God is sufficient. The love of God is complete. The love of God truly satisfies. While we have relationships, it is common, it is normal to have relationships. We have our parents, we have our siblings, and we have our special someone, and maybe a husband and a wife or some. But the thing and the bottom line is, it's God's love that ultimately satisfies. And without the love of God, we could not, you know, bring out the best in the person whom we say we love. E mahimong dili siya hingpit, dili kumpito. And this season as well, nagawas sa mga commercials, And we've heard and we've seen, probably some of you have seen all those commercials of jelly. Well, there's one commercial I'd like to show you. And it goes.
Let us understand how is love best shared, how is
love best lived. And let us experience genuine love. That's why last week we talked about this woman who experienced God's genuine love. He was deceived many times, but he experienced Jesus not discriminating him. And Jesus pouring out his love to this woman. And so many of us could relate to that. Many of us, we want this kind of love. And here is the story of this guy who said, "Yes, I know, love is the answer, love is the key." And then Jesus said, "If you do it, you will live." But the man, he wanted to justify his actions. So he asked Jesus, "And who is my neighbor?" Right? Now a lot of things can happen there. What he was trying to say is that, yeah, I love God, but he really doesn't want to act it. He loves God, but claro siya ginamoy, he has less concern for other people. You know why I said that in a little while. And so Jesus answered him, his question, with a question. And so Jesus said, Jesus replied in a story. A Jewish man was traveling from Jerusalem down to Jericho, and he was attacked by bandits. They stripped him of his clothes, beat him up, and left him half dead beside the road. By chance, a priest came along, but when he saw the man lying there, he crossed to the other side of the road and passed him by. A temple assistant walked over and looked at him lying there, but he also passed by on the other side. Then a despised Samaritan came along, and when he saw the man, he felt compassion for him. Going over to him, the Samaritan soothed his wounds with olive oil and wine and bandaged them. Then he put the man on his own donkey and took him to an inn where he took care of him. The next day he handed the innkeeper 2 silver coins, telling him, "Take care of this man. If his bill runs higher than this, I'll pay you the next time I'm here." Now, Jesus said, "Which of these 3 would you say was a neighbor to the man who was attacked by bandits?" And the man replied, "The one who showed him mercy." And Jesus said, "Yes, now go and do the same." Jesus replied and answered back this man's query with another question, which somehow puts the knife sa iyang chest. In other words, kita nato, this guy only wants to love by words. He only wants to say, "I go to church." He only wants to say, "I'm a good guy, I'm religious." People want to show and broadcast their love superficially. But here God is saying, the one who's truly loved is the person na ilaha magaling yung na-despise. Last week we talked about the Samaritan woman who was not dealing with the Jews. Because Jewish people, okay, they could see these Samaritans, or somehow they're half-relative, or half-brother, half-sister. Because these are kapamilya nila who was married a people na dili nila pareho grace. Right? Probably Moabites or others. Okay, so they are considered contaminated. And so they look down on these Samaritans, but somehow it is a Samaritan na nitabang. The priest who is supposed to be helping, who is supposed to show compassion, pass to the other side, and gibiyaan niya ang tao na kikawatan, and was left half dead. The temple assistant was also known to be a person of service, na nagatabang, religious at that, gibiyaan ang gyapo niya, he also passed to the other side. But however, this Samaritan, okay, he showed love and compassion. And that's where Jesus derived a lesson. And he's trying to tell us, Okay, this morning, as we have shared characteristics of true love, this morning is about seeing love in action. Love isn't just a word. Love is an action word. Love is a verb. Love is not just a word. It is an action word. Loves me, he loves me not. Kaya mga tao, may lang sa istorya, mga paasa tayo. Usahay babae, usahay atong nanay. Paasa. Ang tanag. Nain sa'yo, ito ang sud-anay. Ang haniha, sa lamisa, pili lang. Ang tanag, bulad raman ni nain sa'yo, pilihan. Pili lang muka o dili. Si nanay, paasa. O di ba ka, nain? Ang sa'yo, sud-anay. Anawa lang niya, nasa ref. Ang anak, po ang magbuntay ref, nain. Now, why sud-an? Common sense. Paasa, usahay si nanay, usahay itong crush. Ano ba, maayaw kayo mo diskarte. Labi na rin yung mga panahon na mayroon sila na day. May galingya na ako kung kalingon akong taskan, akong presyo para tao yung kalingon mahal. Oh, kamo ba, mayroon nga, day na ang tawag. However you call her, mayang bagaday, abi na po sa una ang dagat ay mataog, apil man di ay akong feelings ni mo seeking mataog. Amen. Dagang mga hugot, ay mga bala ang kalaghanan, huwag na lang tapat sa hugot mo. Wow. Ano ba, advance kayo ang panahon na uyapaya ang anak niya ay wala ka lang siya kapalun. Advance, future tense. Marag, kung may isa na matanda sa sakasadyante, isa may past tense sa laba, naglaba. Kung sa may present tense sa laba, nanglaba. Kung sa future tense sa laba, nanghay-hay. Sige na pag huwag kang masyadong advance. Sometimes when we're trying to guess, he loves me not, magunaan ang muna-huna. But this morning, tanaw na to, the kinds of relationship. And from our story, we can deduce, we can look, we can observe, there are different types of relationship. And when we look at these relationships, these aspects, you can say, whether you are truly loved, or maybe it's just infatuation, or maybe nagpapabangkir lang ka. He loves me not. The first type of relationship, ingon niya, the story goes that a Jewish man was traveling from Jerusalem down to Jericho. He was attacked by bandits. They stripped him of his clothes, beat him up, left him half dead beside the road. Now this morning, I want you to picture yourself as the man in this story. Ikaw, ninyo tao, ang nasa storya. And figure out for yourself what is love and how is it best expressed. Naunas naman, ikaw ni ikulata. And this type of relationship is what we see as an abusive relationship. It's ironic how so many people, they stay in an abusive relationship and calls that relationship a love relationship. And sometimes, no, makita nato na mawalagi na pagkamarkir sa relasyon. Now, there are many ways to look at it and doon ay mga relationship between a husband and a wife where the partner becomes abusive. And yes, you have your reason to stay. Yes, you have your reason to fight for love. And that is understandable. Obviously, you don't put yourself into a dangerous situation. Okay? Pray sa mga Ilonggo, mga Ilongga, kung mag-away ng dali, sweet kihapon ng tingon. Diba? So to, na kayo, ang babae, kukuha ang konsilyo, kanyang mga tungga, buntang nagtaroon. Ayaw paminaw sa tono, tanawa ang konsilyo. Ay mailan ka. Abusive relationships. Now we cannot help it because without God in our lives, we can be in an abusive relationship. Ikaw ang i-abuse or ikaw ang mang-abuse or nang-abuse. And in this case, we talk about, you know, and the desire. Nasabog na istorya before, ito ka mo kumpare, ikaw siya ka, pray. Kita na ko sa inyo ang dili ko under Isaiah. Samot na ko pre, unang sa kukul. Okay, abot mo ang mga sawa ron. Awa, abot ang mga sawa ka ron. Nasutunan ka niya, abot ang sa mga sawa ni Juan, siya na, Juan, paulay na, galina rin ka niya ang buntang sa hinanan. Isa gita ni Juan, ikaw ay ulit! Hindi ka nasawa. Hindi ba naman ni Juan ay? So, inuan tayo si Pedro na sige lang, ako ang asawa ng Lord, niya ako ang asawa ng Pedro, imam si, imam ang asawa ng Pedro, ulit na rin, kanina nakapunta niya, sige, inong, paulit na rin. Isigahan ng mata ni Pedro, ulit ang asawa ng Lord. Ah, bibili ba naman niyo Pedro? Pero na istorya, niya ako ang asawa ni Carlo, pangabot, Carlo, ulit na, kanina nakapunta, di, kaya mo ulit niya. Wahi ka na ni Carlo niyang sarina anak. Ipakita sa tato, uli ang asawa, tatlo. Iyon ang ilang barkada si Juan Pedro. Carlo, grabe, antir ka niyong asawa sa ito. Ipakita ka naman tato, ngiga ko niyo. Kusa mo yung nakasuwat ka niyo? Pagtanong nila ang nakasuwat, musunod na ako. Hindi mo tapat kung hindi mo na asawa, musunod na ako. When you are in an abusive relationship, it's not easy. When you are, this is a battered husband. Okay? Hindi ko under, I'm just maintaining peace and order. Nonetheless, you have your right, you have your reason to stay in that relationship. You're in covenant with one another. To marry someone, you'll be like in sickness and in health. For poorer, for richer, till death do us part. But it is your obligation, okay, in this story, this man was attacked by bandits. And there are situations that our relationship will be attacked. And our relationship will always be attacked by the devil. Will always insinuate situations where it's either the guy or the woman. Do not put yourself, if you have a choice, if you still have a choice, do not put yourself into a relationship na mahimong hindi maayo para sa iyo. Mahimong abusive relationship. Iyon kanina, anong pinagkaiba ng bobo at tanga sa pag-ibig? Ang bobo, walang ginagawa. Ang tanga, lahat ginagawa. Yang dapat bobo ka ba o tanga? Sometimes it's harsh. We live in a life where you know it's unfair, especially in love. And we can be victims of this kind of relationship. I can be abusive to my wife in my words. I can be harsh. I can be rude. R-O-A-D. I can be so rude to him, to her. And she would feel that. And at times, she can be, you know, she can be abusive as well in the way she might handle me, she might treat me. We do that at times. We see, we're hurting each other a lot. Kusunta yung mga pagkasakit. Or kusunta mag-martir para sa guma. But the God kind of love is not an abusive love. But we need to watch out how these things unfold. And as Jesus was sharing this story, he was also showing us the facets of a man's heart. okay? Like this guy, he was beaten up. And we could be beaten up every single day sa tuwang mga kinabuhi. And if you don't want to enter a relationship that is abusive, all the more reason we come to the Lord and say, Lord, O guard my heart above all else, for out of it overflows the issues of life. If na yung tapad, guard your heart. Secondly, as we have read, you know, a priest came along, but when he saw the man lying there, he crossed to the other side of the road and passed him by. And this shows us the second type. We thought it's love. He loves me, but it's not the kind of love that we want. And that is the hypocritical kind of love, or the hypocritical relationship. Being a hypocrite, a person who claims or pretends to have certain beliefs about what is right, but behaves in a way that disagrees with those beliefs. This is a situation of a relationship na may lagsturya. Dahil ihigugma ko ikaw, pero pagkahuman sa tanan, bibiyaan na. Sakit ko lang naon, but, you know, we should be experiencing, you know, this loving relationship, this genuine relationship in the context sa itong mga panimalay, where our moms, our dads, they're supposed to love us. They're supposed to express in love, a loving relationship with us. But it becomes hypocritical. It becomes maayo lang sa istorya or maayo lang sa sinugdanan. Hindi maayo ang relationship. Hypocritical. And so even when we are in a relationship with our husband or sa imuang asawa, we need to guard our hearts from being hypocrites. We need to watch what we say. Kung ano sa'yo ang istorya, you need to mean it. And again, we can be victims of this. You search and you evaluate your heart. Is your love hypocritical? Is your love abusive? It's the person whom you say you love. Check kung ano mo ang iyong istorya. Diyan sa iyo ang mama. Diyan sa iyo ang papa. Yes, they want special someone, even to your siblings. We must put out a genuine love. We must not put a holier-than-thou attitude like the priest walking along, wherein we are supposed to care, but we did not care. Maybe because we don't want to be contaminated. Maybe because we think I of ourselves. Maybe because, he deserves it. Mona yung nanak. So whatever the reason, again, it's not just us ang nagbuhat, but many times kita ang nagbuhatan. And we become victims of hypocritical relationships or hypocritical expressions of love. And so that's why we are disappointed with our parents. That's why we can be disappointed with a leader. We can be disappointed at our political leaders, spiritual leaders, or any form of leadership because we felt betrayed. We think he should love me, but istorya naman nila. We are not perfect, okay? But then when we feel betrayed, especially with people whom we respect, so it becomes very hard issue. It becomes a challenge for a relationship to stay together. The more you get to know your husband, the longer you spend time with your wife, the more you see each other's flaws, the more you see each other's weaknesses, but will you remain loving each other? And so let us deal with this issue of being hypocritical in our relationships. Hindi na ito kupyahon ang samaong istorya na maayo lang by reputation, maayo na sa tubangan, sa kadaghanan, no? Loving kayo, and holding hands, and smile, and selfie, kundi kumot ako. Let's not being hypocritical, but rather let us start sharing genuine love. But then again, we cannot do it. We have been pained and we have experienced these negative things in a relationship for a long time. The third type of a relationship here is a temple assistant walking over, looking at that person lying, and he also passed by on the other side. This is a type of relationship where it's shallow. A shallow relationship. Kanang sa sinugdanan lang maayo. Kanang relationship na nagamit lang ka or nagamit lang ka. See, God wants a deep relationship. He wants to start an awesome, a vibrant relationship with you. But you don't understand that automatically because in this world, it is the survival of the fittest. It is how you show yourself, present yourself, sell yourself to the other person. And love becomes a commodity. Love becomes a product. Love becomes a business transaction. I love you because I can get something out of you, and obviously you can get something out of me. Love becomes shallow. That does not allow our love to become shallow. As a temple assistant, it's meant to help, it's meant to serve. In a relationship, we are meant to help, we are meant to serve. Kung kapuyan na tayo ng servisyo, kapuyan na galing tagtabang sa mga tao na atong resulting ng kihigugma, check basit shallow na ang ato ang relationship. And again, we can be victims sa niya. A lot of us fall prey to a relationship na maayo lang sa sinugdanan. Sinugdanan ko na yung tapat ng experience na ganun. Maayo lang sa sinugdanan. And it's painful. All of us fell to this relationship and we say, Kabaitan, sumay sayo na ako. Sumay lang nami sa sinugdanan. And all these three so far, nakita na ko, at one point or the other, we have experienced this. We have been abused by people who said they love us. We have been disappointed by people who said they love us, but then only by their words. And then we are hurt by people who said they love us, who think and think, but then when hard times come, they would leave us. And those are all because the relationship is shallow. But the fourth type of relationship, as we can see, no other than and from a person whom we least expected to come from, or at least they least expected to come from, and that is from a despised Samaritan. Someone na wala sila nag-expect na makakita sila gugma. A despised Samaritan came along. When he saw the man, he felt compassion for him. Now you see, he went to him. Samaritan rather went and soothed his wounds with olive oil and wine, bandaged them. He put the man on his own donkey. He took great effort to show love. Seeing that the guy, this fallen guy, was abused, was betrayed, he took an effort. He showed genuine love para nini na tao. Nigastos siya para nini na tao. And he was trying to protect a reputation. I must help you because, I'm civilized from ako. And he was even a despised person. Nobody expected help from him. You see, that only proves that his love is not hypocritical. His love is not only shallow, na iyan ipakita, iyan lang itabangan, iyan lang ipalingkod sa kilid. No, he spent money. He took the time until this guy is fully rehabilitated. His love is deep enough. And so, we are searching for this kind of love. were searching for a genuine love. And we could not find this. All these three characteristics or three aspects of relationship, we find this many times sa atuang pares. Makita nato this kong mama, makita nato this kong papa, makita nato this kong igsuod, makita nato this atuang partner sa kinabuhi. That they can be abusive, they can be hypocritical, they can be shallow. But you know what? In all these things, God wants to tell us today that with His love, we can never doubt His love. He will never deceive us. He's never discriminated us. God's love is genuine. And so like this Samaritan woman, makita nato, the fourth type of relationship is this, what we call godly relationship. A godly relationship is that relationship that is coming from the Lord. This morning, you know, as we focus on these four things, and let's evaluate our hearts. Lord, asa man po yari? It's very important for us to have a heart check. Talk to our hearts, hear heart. It's very important for us to be honest, to be sincere. It's a bit of a straightforward message, but it's really time for us to be sincere and have an introspective look at ang mga pinabuhi. First, ask yourself, have I been abusive about Paris? How are you with your words? Sa mga mangana. How are you with your words? Sa mga bana or sa mga asawa? Nakapasakit ba ka? Young people, how have you been sa inyong mga parents? Did you talk back to them? Now, sometimes when I talk to JB, I say something, and he will not talk back. He will be disciplined if he will talk back. But at times, I will tell him to do something, and he's so busy seeking tanaw ka sa ipara at na siya yung nabuha. So, I tell him, JB, I'll raise my voice. Then, he would look at me. Now, tell him, pay attention when that is telling you something. And he would be saying, yes, Papa. Next time, okay? You pay attention. He would not, he would say, nanay ko nana. Okay? And it's very important for me to do alam po kong panganak na maayos sila to respond. As much as gusto na ako to respond to my kids nicely. So even with that little gesture of my son not responding well, sakitan ko. And how much more ako? Yes, ang pag binikanan. And before I understood the love of God, gusto ko rin ang tubag-tubag. Uwi ba ito, mag-lula? Tubag-tubag muna ako. And medyo na siya, deliberate siya na sa nangyayahan na sa mga sakit, sa mga igulang, sinilig. Okay? Na ako mga hinay-hay sa sito, iyan ipisaka, isang basakta. Ako na po ibalik ko, hey, sito, iyan ako isaka. Ano ito siya, kawatog. Sorry, kawato na ngayon. So, atulog na ko na, nahinay din na siya kama, and now to see ko, hindi na po, buglaso. So, mag-away niya na kumula, sa'yo masinghaga na po, puko sa iya. And when she died, really broke my heart. But I was already a Christian. When I became a Christian, I felt so sorry for her. I started to treat her right. And when she died, really broke my heart. You see, we cannot treat people right if we don't have the love of God. We can be so abusive to the people, you know, around us. And sometimes you say, I love you, gusto mo na lang, I love you, pero hindi ka kapit ko sa puno ka na ako. That's being hypocritical. And we say, I love you, but, you know, hindi ka makahatag sa isang puno, uro, uras sa ilahan. And that's being shallow. Come on, let's do a heart check this morning. We want to go back and desire for this godly relationship, this godly life. And let's all stand. And I want you to meditate for a little while. You see, if you do not have the love of God, this is God telling you today, no other love can truly satisfy. No other love can fulfill and fill you with so much joy. It's only the love of God. Even if you try to be so loving, and even if you have the most loving person on earth, you don't have the love of God. That person hears, makes a mistake, you know, everything will fall apart. Father, we come before you today and we desire for that heart that comes from you. Lord, we desire for you to heal our hearts right now. Come on, and this morning, if you have been abusive, kasakit ka ba kasi mama, si papa, sa dapat na imong hinihugman, sa dapat imong kitabangan, ask the Lord for forgiveness. This is a time of healing. This is a time for you to say, Lord, I'm sorry. And I'll give you a few seconds to do that. If you want, if you have been shallow, change how you treat the people around you. Don't take people around you for granted. If this morning you are the one being hurt, I want you to come before God. I want you to surrender your heart before the Lord. And say, Lord, here's my heart. It's been abused. I face false people in my life. They said they love me, but they're just a bunch of hypocrites. Pasakit sila sa buwan. Lord, I have been hurt by people who said they are committed, but at a very slight difficulty, they left me half dead. If that is you, that is God wants to heal your heart right now. And I want to tell you this morning that it is only when you draw near to God, it is not only when you give your heart to the Lord that you can truly function. As a husband, as a wife, as a son, as a daughter. The greatest expression of love is the cross. And you know that. But love would not be complete without Jesus. So when he spread his arms, he's saying, I'm not gonna abuse you. I'm not gonna be a hypocrite who says, I love you, and then go back to the United States. My love for you is not gonna be shallow. It will be forever. And so this morning, if you don't have a personal relationship with Jesus, I want you to come to Him. I want you to recognize Him today. I want you to say to the Lord, Lord, here's my heart. I want you, God, to put this back together. Amen. Come on, let's put our hands together. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus for every heart that has been abused and that has been a sin, hypocrisy. Lord, for every heart that's let down by people who said they love them but yet they withdraw their love. Lord, I pray for your healing. I pray for your comfort. I pray for your touch upon their lives. God is touching you. God is healing you where it's hurting right now. because that is who He is. He is a healer. You cannot give love if you haven't received love. And so as a person that has been beaten, as a person that has been lying down half dead, God is telling you, I am your healer. And soon you'll be standing on your feet and you'll be out there helping other people. Lord, thank you for your love. Thank you for your goodness. Ikaw lang Ginoo ang makakumpleto sa ama. Ikaw Ginoo ang magatagpaw sa mga ama that has worshiped me.
Christian Center podcast. For more updates, like our page on Facebook at City Gates Christian Center or visit us at citygatescebu.org.